the x-ray, these are the densities, relative densities. In fact, they have impact on the chest radiograph, and the different image pattern are due to the difference in the densities of the materials in the body, like the gas which is less dense and seen in the ear or trachea appear as more black, and the bone which is denser and compact appear as white. The metal is the most white thing. Water is also somewhat white. The fat is also grayish black in the chest x-ray. There are certain factors which quantify the quality of the x-ray or radiograph, especially in the chest. The inspiration has an important role. There is also the factor of the penetration, which is controlled by the technician by using certain tools like MAS and KVP. But you don't want to read these things, because this is the physics and this is not in your curriculum. And the next thing is the rotation of the patient. Patient should be in the straight position, and it should be in the midline. Any of you, if ever have gone with your grandpa or grandma or father or mother, have seen how the x-ray is going on, or if you have like some rotation in the radiology department, you can see we asked the patient when he or she came to the radiology department for having chest x-ray, please change the gown, which is devoid of any button or any metallic object, and we ask him or her to wear a simple cotton gown which is available in our department, or patient may come with the simple cotton clothes without any pin, zip or any other metallic thing or anything, and the chest x-ray can be done. He or she is asked to take a full deep breath maximally, which he or she can. Why? Because the lungs expand maximally, and we can see the claustrophrenic angle and the cardiophrenic angles also. Why? Because maximally and the fluid accumulates in the claustrophrenic angles, and slight blunting of the angles might be very informative to the regarding the disease of the patient. At full inspiration, the diaphragm also moves down, and it is roughly 8 to 10th rib posteriorly, or the 5th to 6th rib anteriorly. This is the chest x-ray, AP view or PA view, posterior anterior view. Why? I missed the thing. Usually the chest x-ray is in the PA view position. Why? Because we only adopt AP chest x-rays in the child who cannot stand, like babies, neonates, etc., and in the very sick ICU patient, because in these patients the AP chest radiograph are taken, and the multiple abnormalities are hidden by the enlarged heart, which is actually not enlarged. In AP view, the heart shadow is so bigger that it obscures the fine details and the many, many pathologies. This is the beautiful chest x-ray, simple normal chest x-ray. You can see different densities, like you can see these are the clavicles. This is the lung parenchyma. You can see here, these are the fine bronchi or like bronchovascular markings. You can see the tiny, and these are the claustrophrenic angles. These both are so sharp. This is the humerus, and this is the acromion and coronoid and the scapula. In the center, you can see the trachea, and these are the vertebrae. So these are the posterior ribs, and these are the anterior ribs, which are obliquely placed. This is the stomach bubble, stomach gas shadow, and it is normal. It is the bowel shadow. It is also normal. This is the shadow of the pulmonary trunk, pulmonary right branch of the pulmonary artery. Underexposure. If an underexposed chest radiograph, the cardiac shadow is opaque and there is no visibility of the thoracic vertebra. The lungs may appear much denser and whiter, and they might be misinterpreted as infiltrates. You can see this is the normal chest X-ray. This is the underexposed and this is the overexposed. The greater exposure of the chest radiograph, the heart becomes more radiolucent and the lungs become darker. In an overexposed chest X-ray, the air-filled lung periphery becomes extremely radiolucent and often gives the appearance of lacking lung tissue. So it might be misinterpreted as emphysema. You can see this. This is an overexposed lung film. So this is not good for anyone, not for any purpose, for any for picking any pathology or any other. So consultant or the simple doctor will say ki kis tarah ka x-ray karaya aapne. Now the positions. Normally we adopt, I have already told you, posterior anterior view. What is posterior anterior view? In which the X-ray beam comes from behind and the cassette or the recording is in the front of the front portion of the chest, and we ask the patient to open the scapula and touch the cassette from the chest wall and put the chin on the chest chin rest, so that everything will be straight and the optimal position is acquired. If we have some we think there is some collapse or some pathology and we want to locate in which segment of the lung or in which lobe of the lung is it lying, so we ask for the lateral film. Anterior posterior film, as I have already told you, are done in the neonates, in the infants, in the patients who are in ICU, cannot stand. And the lateral decubitus film, which is usually for the effusion, pleural effusion, or any pyopneumothorax or hydropneumothorax, in which we want to know, and the effusion is so small that we cannot see on the PA or lateral view, and we ask the patient to lie down on the position for few minutes, around 5 to 6 minutes, and then the X-ray is shoot down. Normal X-ray, I have told you, there are clavicles, trachea, spinous process. This is the pulmonary trunk. You can see okay, this is the pulmonary trunk. You can see the convexity. This is the aortic arch. These are the heart borders. This is in the midline, there is heart. The CP angle, ribs, I have already told you. This is the lateral chest X-ray. You can see the spines. These are the vertebral bodies, and these are the intervertebral discs. These are the posterior bony elements. You can see the trachea, heart is here. You can see the trachea and the different, these are the bronchi. Now in this X-ray, this is the AP X-ray, anterior posterior X-ray. You can see okay, there are certain things, certain wires are going on, so you can predict okay, this is an ICU patient. And you can see it seems to be that there is sort of some cardiomegaly, enlarged heart, and pleural effusion bilaterally, and the mediastinum is also so much widened, some mediastinal injury is here, But this is not the case. This is an APX ray. We are all misinterpreting the things due to the APX ray. So if you are reading the APX ray, and how can you assess the enlarged shadow? Large shadow of the heart, you can see the much straighter picture of the clavicles and these ICU wires, lateral decubitus. You can see the patient has effusion with ear fluid level, and he rest few minutes on the side affected. And this is the, as I have already told you earlier, the fluid is white, and you can see with the right arrow this portion of the chest is completely blackish, and this is the half blackish on the upper side. As always, the air goes upward and the water comes downward. So this is the lateral decubitus film. Anatomical structures in the chest. They are mediastinum, hilum, lung fields, diaphragmatic domes, pleural surfaces, bones, and soft tissues. Mediastinum. What you would like to see in the mediastinum? The trachea should be centrally located or slightly towards right. The aortic arch is the first convexity on the left side of the mediastinum, I have told you. The pulmonary artery is the next convexity on the left, and the branches should be traceable as it fans out through the lungs. And the lateral margin of the SVC, superior vena cava, lies above the right heart border. Heart, 2/3 of the heart should lie on the left side of the chest, with 1/3 on the right. The heart should take up less than half of the thoracic cavity. Cardiothoracic ratio must be less than 50%. And the left atrium and the left ventricle create the left heart border. The right heart border is created entirely by the right atrium, and the right ventricle lies anteriorly and therefore does not have a border on the radiograph hilum. Hilum consists primarily of the major bronchi and the pulmonary veins and the arteries. They are usually not symmetrical, but contain some basic structure which I have already told you. They may be at the same level, but the left hilum is usually higher than the right, and both hilum should be of similar size and density. Lungs are usually show the markings throughout the lungs. They are usually due to the pulmonary arteries and the vein, and they are continuing along the way to the chest wall. Both lungs should be scanned, starting from at the apices and working downward, comparing the left and right lung fields at the same level as it is done with auscultation. On a chest radiograph, the minor fissure can often be seen as a faint horizontal line dividing the right middle lobe from the right upper lobe, and the major fissures are not usually seen on the posterior anterior view because they are being viewed obliquely. Now, the bones are white in color, and the calcification also appears as white. You can see fluid or blood white in color, and looks white in the sometime in the vessels, and the normal ear is black. This is the minor fissure. These are the oblique fissures, which are called major fissures. Diaphragm. Usually the left dome is slightly lower than the right due to elevation by the liver. Located under the right hemidiaphragm, and the costophrenic recesses or angle are formed by the hemi diaphragms and the chest wall. On the PA radiograph, the costopharynx recess is seen only on each side, where an angle is formed by the lateral chest wall and the dome of each hemi diaphragm, costopharynx angle. Pleura and the pleural spaces will only be visible when there is an abnormality present. Common abnormalities seen in the pleura include pleural thickening, fluid, air in the pleural space. In the bones, we want to know ribs, clavicle, scapula, vertebra, and proximal humeri. First, I would like, as I have told you all the things, I would like to go back and want to show you the normal chest X-ray. I am again repeating because I have told you the text. This is the CP angle, costophrenic angle. This is the cardiophrenic angle. Slight blunting is due to the flat in the cardiophrenic angle. These are the highlights. You can see that usually they are symmetrical. There are some opacities in it which are due to the pulmonary vessels, including vein, arteries, and some small lymph nodes. If there are some enlarged nodes, then we can see enlarged hyla. I will tell you later. This is the right heart border. This is the left heart border. This is the diaphragm. You can see. And this is the trachea. I am repeating it. This is the aortic shadow. And on just above is the SVC, superior vena cava shadow. Now, some abnormal chest radiographs, because you will get bored if I will not show you anything extra. Slit sign. This is a very common terminology used in the radiology regarding chest X-ray. It is seen when the borders of the heart, aorta, chest wall, they are obscured. Usually seen in consolidation or collapse. You can see that there is an area of consolidation collapse with air bronchogram in the right middle lobe, and the right heart border is not that much clearly defined. This is called slit sign, air bronchogram. Air bronchogram are the linear branching things. You can see that there is a whitish area of consolidation, and you can see the tiny branching structure which is air filled. These are the area of air bronchogram seen in consolidation, pulmonary edema, non-obstructive pulmonary atelectasis, interstitial disease, neoplasm, and normal expiration. Consolidation. This can be due to pus, fluid, blood, or cells. Now you can see there is an area of consolidation collapse in the left lower lobe. Atelectasis means collapse of the lung, volume loss, which indicates itself as a vascular crowding, rib crowding, and elevation of the hyla, etc. But this is not our topic for today. Then you can see complete collapse of the lung. Left lung is not visualized, and the right lung is hyperinflated. Then you can see the consolidation collapse of the right upper lobe with elevation of right hyla. You can see both hyla are also enlarged. This is due to some neoplastic lesion in the right upper lobe, which causes secondary atelectasis and elevation of the hyla with bilateral enlarged hilar nodes. This is a case of cardiomegaly. You can see we cannot clearly see, and along with some pleural effusion on the left, which is indicative as a blunting of the left CP angle. Heart is more than the 50% of the, we can measure it by drawing a line from here to here, measuring it, and then drawing a line from the this whole chest wall, and if it is more than half, it means cardiomegaly. Pneumonias are air space opacity, lobar consolidation, interstitial opacities. They can be seen with air bronchogram and collapse. The opposite lung try to overcome it and it is hyperinflated. Pleural effusion, you can see, I am just bypassing the slides because topic for today was the simple chest x-ray, but I am showing you these things because I think if you will not, you are not shown the pathology, you are not interested in the simple normal topic. So bilateral pleural effusion, blunting of the CP angles. Pneumothorax means collection of air in the pleural cavity. You can see, okay, there are no lung markings beyond this line. Pleural pneumothorax, pulmonary edema. You can see ICU wires multiple, the chest, the x-ray is AP chest x-ray, and you cannot see the lung marking, the lungs clearly, there are white shadowing. Congestive cardiac failure and large heart with bilateral bat wing appearance and the, some pleural effusion. Then these, you can see the curly B lines, pulmonary edema. Then emphysema. Emphysema seems to be like overinflated lungs. There is more air than the normal in the normal alveoli, and the diaphragms are usually flat, and there are lungs are overinflated. Then lung mass, you can see some mass, soft tissue density in anywhere in both lung fields. It is in the left perihilar region in this case. Then some bony abnormalities like fracture of the ribs, they can also be seen. You can see that the fracture of the different ribs. And there is some emphysema, subcutaneous emphysema, fracture of the clavicle. Then there is mediastinum is fine. There are pulmonary contusions, evidences, some opacities in the lung field. Then you can see the other structure, chest tube, NG tube. Okay. These are the different things which you have to tell in your exam. If you are observing, you have to tell each and everything which you see. Then pulmonary contusion appearing as opacity, opacified lung in this scapular fracture. You can see the carina, you can see the tip of the endotracheal tube, you can see the deep right main stem intubation. You can see the tip of endotracheal tube. These are the trauma patients usually seen in ICU. Sorry. This is the case of pneumomediastinum. X-ray findings. There is widened mediastinum. This is the mediastinum. You have to also comment on this. There is obliteration of the aortic knob. You cannot see aortic knuckle this size. You can see the right main stem bronchus is somewhat up, and the NG is also deviated to the right mesogastric tube. There is a pleural cap sign. Okay, hemothorax, pleural cavity is filled with blood. Tension hemothorax, it is an emergency, and whether tension hemothorax or pneumothorax, the patient is in a compromised state and with shortness of breath, and immediately The thing which should be done is to put a tube, chest tube, in the ipsilateral chest cavity, liver cavity basically. Diaphragm injuries, you can see the bow is usually seen in the RTA, and you can see the different vowel loops sometimes in the chest cavity. The diaphragm is not clearly visualized and it is irregular, shaky and elevated. Then some allergic bronchopulmonary aspergillosis, you can see finger in glove appearance with multiple bronchoceles. You can see lung abscess, air fluid level. You can see asbestosis, this one. Then lymphoma, usually due to the enlarged hilar nodes. Hampton hump, peripheral, you can see this peripheral triangular wedge-shaped obesity, usually seen in pulmonary embolism. Then multiple metastases, cannonball soft tissue densities in bilateral lung fields. Then TB, you can see multiple tiny sub-centimeter nodules scattered throughout both lung fields. Mediary TB, TB is very common in our society. Summary, clean films can be very effective at detecting many major injuries, sometimes even better than fancier technologies, and they can suggest further needed diagnostic modalities. You can read X-rays.